Major General Kurt Crytzer and Brigadier General Laura Yeager. Our ceremonial music is being provided by the 1st Armored Division Band under the direction of Sergeant Justin Mabry. The Honor Salute Battery was provided by the 1st Armored Division, Division Artillery, and led by 1st Lieutenant Joshua Steele. In response to President George H.W. Bush's declaration of the war on drugs, General Colin Powell, then Commanding General of the U.S. Army Forces Command, issued an order on November 13, 1989, that established Joint Task Force 6 at Fort Bliss, Texas. JTF-6 was established to serve as the planning and coordinating operational headquarters to support local, state, and federal law enforcement agencies within the southwest border region to counter the flow of illegal drugs into the United States. On September 28, 2004, JTF-6 was officially renamed Joint Task Force North, and its mission was expanded to include providing homeland security support to the nation's federal law enforcement agencies. The tactics, techniques, and procedures that the command developed over the years in the war on drugs contribute immeasurably to the accomplishment of Joint Task Force North's broader new mission of combating transnational threats. From its inception as JTF-6 to its evolution as Joint Task Force North, the command has completed over 8,000 missions in direct support of the nation's local, state, and federal law enforcement agencies and counter-drug task forces. Joint Task Force North's Homeland Security role is articulated in the following mission statement. Joint Task Force North supports federal law enforcement agencies in the conduct of counter-drug, counter-transnational organized crime operations, and facilitates Department of Defense training and the U.S. Northcom Theater of Operations to disrupt transnational criminal organizations and deter their freedom of action in order to protect the homeland and increase Department of Defense readiness. The Joint Task Force North staff and Department of Defense professionals are committed to accomplishing the command's mission. Their dedication to the homeland security support role is best summed up in Joint Task Force North's motto, protecting the homeland.
Thank you.
bike chaplain, Fort Bliss deputy installation chaplain, Lieutenant Colonel Liao.
Let me pray. Almighty God, may your promise be quoted by the prophet Jeremiah be a guidance for us today, who says, "But blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in him. They will be like trees planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when heat comes. Its leaves are always green. It has no worries in the year of drought and never fails to bear fruit." Lord, we give you praise and thanks for Major General Crytzer and Mrs. Crytzer's distinguished command and leadership. Their commitment inspires confidence and assurance of success to all they have led. Their effortless and selfless service is a testament to their dedication to the command, the U.S. military, and our great nation. May God give you the desire of your heart and make all your plans succeed, now and during the next phase of your journey. Lord, we welcome the command team of Brigadier General Yeager and her family. Allow your generous blessing to descend upon her as she assumes this vital role. May the God of steadfastness and encouragement grant you wisdom in your command. His rod and staff comfort you in time of challenge and lead you on the path of righteousness and peace. I pray that you will bless our service members, civilians, and their family members. Thank you for your never-ending love, strength, and guidance, the keys to unlocking the full potential of this outstanding organization. In God we trust. Amen.
Amen.
The members of Joint Task Force North would like to extend a warm welcome to our distinguished guests, including Mr. Tom Thomas, civilian aide to the Secretary of the Army for West Texas. We would also like to welcome the families of Major General Crytzer and Brigadier General Yeager, including Major General Crytzer's wife, Mrs. Simona Crytzer, and his son, Mr. Brandon Crytzer, and Brigadier General Yeager's father, Major General Retired Robert Brandt, and his fiancée, Chief Warrant Officer IV Retired Jacqueline Zist. Brigadier General Yeager's sister, Mrs. Kelly Buttram, and her niece, Miss Morgan Buttram. Brigadier General Yeager's daughter-in-law and stepson, Mrs. Kelly Yeager and Mr. Robert Yeager. Joint Task Force North would also like to welcome our visiting general and flag officers, law enforcement partners, and civic leaders. Thank you all for attending. Mrs. Crytzer will be presented a bouquet of red roses to thank her for her dedication to the Joint Task Force North family. These flowers symbolize the essential role of spouses in the organization and the Fort Bliss community. At this time, the salute battery officer in charge, First Lieutenant Joshua Steele, will present Major General Crytzer an expanded shell case. Ladies and gentlemen, the responsibility for command of Joint Task Force North is about to be passed from Major General Crytzer to Brigadier General Yeager with the passing of the Joint Task Force North organizational colors. The passing of the colors was instituted when George Washington was the commander of the Continental Army, and Baron von Steuben initiated drills and ceremonies in the Army's training program. Full responsibility for the unit and its mission. In keeping with the time-honored tradition, Rear Admiral Snyder will preside at the transfer of command. The unit colors are presented to the outgoing commander by the senior enlisted leader to the commander. This role is fulfilled by Command Sergeant Major Timothy S. Dodson. Major General Crytzer will link. Major General Crytzer relinquishes command at Joint Task Force North by returning the unit colors to Rear Admiral Snyder. Admiral Snyder conveys command at Joint Task Force North by presenting the colors to General Yeager. By authority of the commander, United States Northern Command, Brigadier General Yeager assumes command at Joint Task Force North, Fort Bliss, Texas, effective 29 September 2017. Brigadier General Yeager returns the colors to Command Sergeant Major Dodson, the keeper of the colors. Ladies and gentlemen, today's host, Rear Admiral Richard Snyder, Director, Strategy, Policy, and Plans, NORAD, U.S. NORTHCOM J5.
Well, good morning.
Good morning.
What a great day to be serving our nation and here in Fort Bliss, Texas. I got to tell you, the weather in Colorado Springs has been in the 40s and rainy. So I'll take this weather in West Texas any day, although I hear in July it's a little bit different than this area. Is it me, or does it feel like those guns actually, it sure smells like those guns. Hey, on behalf of my boss, General Roy Robinson, the commander of NORAD and U.S. Northern Command, and representing Lieutenant General Buchanan, I'm honored to be a part of today's change of command ceremony between Major General Kirk Crytzer and Brigadier General Laura Yeager. It's not every day that a Navy officer gets the opportunity to preside at a change of command between two Army officers. And although we're inside, I was also promised there was no horses involved. special welcome this morning to the friends and families of the Crytzers and the Yeagers. I know how important it is to Kirk and Laura to have you with them here today. I'd also like to welcome the General Officers, Senior Executive Service, local, state, regional, and federal law enforcement, emergency management, community partners, regional interagency partners, community and business leaders. Thanks for being great teammates here in Texas and across the entire Southwest border. No ceremony like this can be pulled off without the hard work and support from many teams. Sincere thanks to the band, the Honor Salute Battery, the Color Guard, the Protocol Team, and the men and women of Joint Task Force North. Please join me in a round of applause for all of them. To the men and women of Joint Task Force North, it's a real privilege for me to be with you here today. As you've heard, your unit has answered the call since 1989, and I can tell you in my 2 years as the Director of Strategy, Plans, and Policy at U.S. Northern Command, I've seen firsthand the impact of the work we do. We have it easy, relatively speaking, at the headquarters. We come up with the policy and the strategies, and then sit back and let this team do the hard work of making it happen. So my sincere thanks and appreciation and admiration for the things that you've done here at Joint Task Force North. You're an integral part of U.S. Northern Command, our successes, and we couldn't accomplish our mission without you. U.S. Northern Command has three missions: Homeland Defense, Defense Support of Civil Authorities, Theater Security Cooperation with Mexico, Canada, and the Bahamas. JTF-North makes an important impact across all three mission areas, and Kirk Crytzer's leadership has been critical to that success and this command's excellence in all that you do. Excellence is not an action or a result. Excellence is a culture. You don't achieve excellence by accident or by direction. Excellence is cultivated, nurtured, and propagated throughout an organization. The culture that encourages excellence is shaped by each of our service's core values and ethos. Although each service is different, their core values and ethos combine to create a culture ripe for excellence. For the Air Force, it's excellence in all we do. For the Army, there's a value of selfless service. And for the Department of the Navy, our Navy and Marine Corps, it's honor, courage, and commitment. It's apparent that it's a coming together of these service core values that really describes the culture of this command. These core values are about getting the job done under any condition, without excuse, and with honor. It leads to an aura of quiet professionalism that lets the results speak for themselves. One can see these values in every aspect of JTF North. From the South Texas RST to the joint staff, from a ground surveillance platoon to an engineering detachment, to your L&O cell at the AMOC. The selfless commitment to duty in this command is universal, and the standard of achievement is excellence. Your innovation and creativity in finding more effective and efficient ways to support our law enforcement partners is apparent in efforts as wide-ranging as the employment of aerial sensors for change detection, a budding partner with JTF South for the maritime approaches to the United States, and on working with air agency partners to deploy Department of Defense UAVs in national airspace. Your unwavering sense of duty and commitment to excellence are evident in every task that you do. Organizations are a reflection of their leadership, and that is certainly the case for JTF North. Major General Kirk Crytzer drew on his exceptional operational experience in numerous combatant commands to take on an already outstanding command to new levels of excellence. Kirk is a warrior. His significant joint and interagency experience from his special operations background, combined with an engaging manner and a sense of duty to really listen to our law enforcement partners and help them meet their needs. The best example that I can think of is the RSTs. Your ability to hear your partners and then adapt your organization to better support their needs led to many team successes you've helped achieve. Kirk, on behalf of the entire Northcom team, I want to thank you for a job exceedingly well done. We're going to miss you. As you leave, know that you made a huge impact on JTF North, Northern Command, and the United States. Good luck in all of your future endeavors. I know you'll make a difference in whatever you do and wherever you go. The good news is that our system is really good at finding truly exceptional leaders as relief for departing commanders. Brigadier General Larry Yeager is just such a leader. No stranger to the NORTHCOM team or our varied missions, Laura comes to us from serving as both the dual status commander and director of the joint staff in the state of California. I'm confident that she'll maintain the culture of excellence and take this command to even greater heights. Laura, welcome to the NORTHCOM team. We have the watch.
Ladies and gentlemen, the outgoing commander, Major General Kirk Crytzer.
The thing about these tall guys is then you gotta. I usually don't need this anyhow, but, you know, I've been known to go off script, you know, a time or two. But, you know, I'll try to stick to it as much as I can, but I'm extremely honored to see you all out here. I mean, amongst this crowd, I've got many friends, colleagues. And it's just a big honor, and I'm very humbled that you all took time out of your day to come here. So thank you for that. I want to echo also a thanks for the band and everybody else, all the people in JTF North that helped put this together. It's not going to happen without them. You guys are always great every time you show up. Likewise with the firing battery, except for one time where they forgot the firing pin. Sorry about that. But they are outstanding. The support we get here on post is amazing with 1st Armored Division. So again, I'm just humbled to see you all. Thank you, Admiral, for the kind words. Really appreciate that. Obviously, it's a team effort. You know, I just happen to be the commander, but nothing gets done without the hard work of the men and women of JTF North. I'm really not used to talking into these things because I got a loud voice. So, Rear Admiral Snyder, Mr. Thomas, fellow general officers, command sergeant majors, law enforcement partners, friends and family, and members of JTF North, again, thank you all for being here today. I'm going to break script again, and special recognition to command sergeant major, retired Ken Sargent. Where are you at, Ken? And his wife, Terry. Ken. Operational Detachment Alpha back in Bad Tools, Germany, 10th Special Forces Group. By far the best team in group, I would say. What would you say?
Yeah.
And then went on to do great things with other great units. But anyhow, I really appreciate you and Terry being here today. Thank you very much. So changing command is always a bittersweet occasion, and we use bittersweet way too much, but I can't think of a better word to describe it. Because it's bitter because you're leaving an outstanding unit, mission, and friends that you've made while you're in command. It's sweet because a new commander gets to take over the reins as part of the overall team, do her part to continue to improve and excel in the mission we have been tasked to do. This has been an absolutely phenomenal experience, and I have many to thank. And really, I'm going to spend the bulk of my speech thanking a lot of people. For those of you that know me, and you understand that I always begin with God and family, the Lord has certainly blessed the Crytzer family by allowing us to spend the last 2 years in El Paso. This is where we were meant to be, even though I couldn't spell border when I got here. And I certainly didn't know anything about the complexity of it. And as for family, Simona, I'm one lucky guy to have had you for 28 years, and I'm hopeful we'll have many more years together. You are my rock, and you know that. I love you. Brandon, absolutely proud to be your dad. You've grown up to be a fine young man, and I'm glad you could make it today. Thanks for coming. To the rest of my family, and for those of you that don't know, we're actually filming this, and they're online and able to actually watch it real time, so watch what you say about me. To the rest of my family watching this event remotely, including my daughter Courtney, sisters and brothers, thanks to you for the love and mentoring over the years. I stand here today in a large part because of you all. For meine deutsche Familie, danke für alles, ich liebe dich. To my military partners, Northcom, Army North, Marfor North, Av North, Nav North, my SOC brethren from SOC North. Chris, where are you at?
Right here.
Thanks for coming. Appreciate it. And members of the National Guard, thank you all for your continuous support during my tenure as commander at JTF North. It has been an honor and a pleasure to work with you in the defense of the homeland, and you have all helped make me a better officer. You may not be overflowing with personnel or resources, but you work smartly and do some amazing things for this country, as has been shown recently with the incredible response to the major hurricanes that have struck our country. Obviously, as Rear Admiral Snyder mentioned, General Buchanan, Lieutenant General Buchanan, who was supposed to be here today, is down in Puerto Rico right now, taking charge of such an effort. To my National Guard partners from the Southwest border states, our ability to mutually support each other has been extremely helpful, and your efforts are absolutely essential to success along the border. I ask that all of you give Laura the same support you gave me as she takes over the reins of this command. To my law enforcement agency partners, I will be forever grateful to you all, and I am constantly amazed at your professionalism and effort in protecting the citizens of this country. You face a wicked problem on a daily basis, yet your enthusiasm for upholding the laws of this land never wanes. I am honored to have worked with you and been able to get to know many of you, and if ever in a position to help the cause, rest assured I will. I consider many of you friends now, and again, thank you for attending. I could not have asked for better partners. To the El Paso community, wow, what a great place to live. We love the city, the people, and the hidden gems that are scattered throughout this area. You are the most military-friendly community I have lived in, and Simona and I will miss you all greatly. We've made many great friends here, and for that we are very grateful. From my First Baptist Church group to civilian leaders, to the many events that I've been able to support in the community, we now have a lifelong bond with this city. To the JTF North family, what can I say about you all that I haven't said already? But I'll begin with Command Sergeant Major Dotson. He's truly one of the finest senior NCOs that I've worked with in my 30-year career, and he has certainly kept me on the straight and narrow as much as possible. He is truly the utmost professional, as well as a warrior, mentor, and friend. Thanks, Sergeant Major. My headquarters leadership of Dan, Forrest, Chris, and the rest, as well as my directors, keep up the effort. You are all extremely talented. To the rest of the amazing military and civilian members of this unit, including my regional support teams, or RSTs, the best is yet to come. Key leaders are starting to recognize the true value of JTF North, and I believe this will lead to increased opportunities for us to more effectively support our partners along the southwest border and beyond. But even if nothing changes, you will still provide a valuable service to America. The myriad of threats to this country are real and growing. And while none of us can interdict our way to victory, we can certainly do our part to more effectively support and help develop the overarching whole of government effort. Illegal commodities such as narcotics are damaging our country at an unprecedented rate. Special interest aliens present a clear and growing danger. Violence in parts of Mexico are at the highest levels ever as cartels continue to battle for dominance. The dangers are real, and JTF North will be an increasing part of the response. So in conclusion, Laura, I wish you the best of luck during your tenure as commander of this fine unit. Take it to the next level. As I mentioned earlier, Simone and I feel blessed that we received this assignment, and no matter where we end up in the future, you all will not be far from our thoughts. It is time for me to fade away, but I'll continue to monitor. Reach out to me if I can ever help, and know that I will continue to message for this command, even after I'm gone. I just might have a really cool beard when I'm doing it. So all the best to you. Thank you again for being here. Stay impressively bare and protecting the homeland.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great honor to present to you the commander of Joint Task Force North, Brigadier General Laura Yeager.
Thank you for moving the microphone down. I think a little bit more. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I am thrilled to be back in the great state of Texas, and what a beautiful morning it is. I got to say that Fort Bliss is a vast installation, and as an aviator, I will not admit that I've been lost on Fort Bliss, but I found many different ways to get to the same destination. So many special and pivotal moments in my personal and professional life have occurred here in Texas. Over 30 years ago, as a brand new lieutenant, I started my career in San Antonio. Later spent an assignment as a medevac pilot at Fort Hood, the Great Lakes, they say. Followed by service as an instructor at the AMS Benham School, my youngest son Scott was born in Texas, and I was in the Texas National Guard on 9/11. Definitely memorable times, throughout which I cherished the highs, leaned on my friends, peers, and colleagues and mentors during the lows, and have been generally following my bliss. And now I find myself on Fort Bliss. I didn't get here without the support of my family, especially my husband Curtis, retired Lieutenant Colonel, former medevac pilot, and PhD, PhD in microbiology, currently recovering from knee surgery at home in California. Kurt is my best friend, my sounding board, and he patiently tolerates me. So thank you, hon, I love you. Together we have four sons that we are very proud of, and I'm thrilled to have my oldest stepson, Rob, and my daughter-in-law, Kelly, here with me today. My dad, Major General retired Robert Grant, my original mentor, who is also here with us today, and Mom, though she's passed away over 12 years ago, is never far from my thoughts. She was the best role model a young girl could have. She never took no for an answer, and I would like to think that I didn't have that quality. I'm also thankful to have my sister Kelly and niece Morgan here today. If given the chance, Kelly could certainly tell some stories about me. So. I'm going to have to keep an eye on her. She doesn't tell any of those today. I would be remiss if I didn't acknowledge some very special individuals who have traveled a great distance to be here today. Major General Beavers, the Deputy Adjutant General of California. Brigadier General Kelly Fisher, Colonel Robert Spano, Colonel Richard Raby, Ms. Irma Garrett, and all of us who have seen you, I'm sorry, Sergeant Major Bernard as well, thank you for being here today. Seeing y'all here today really makes me homesick. I miss y'all so much. It's an absolute honor to serve as the commander of this great organization. The colors we just passed have been passed through the hands of superb leaders. And in following Major General Crytzer, I am keenly aware that I have a very high standard to carry forward. In the short amount of time I've been on the ground, it's obvious that he has built a world-class team. And it's an honor and privilege to take it from you, sir. The outstanding professionalism of this staff is apparent, and I am so appreciative of the warm welcome that I've received in the short time that I've been here. I'm fortunate to have been in a position to interact with some of the key stakeholders within DOD's outstanding program, the counter-drug program, for the last several years. The Southwest Border Directors of the Joint Staff, including Major General Tom Baum and Major General Kerry Muhlenbeck, thank you so much for being here today. It means a lot. Colonel Daisy, we've worked together over the last couple of years in several different contexts. Interacted with members of SEDINA, Customs Border Patrol, Drug Enforcement Agency, and all the other partners in this program. It's an extraordinary group of individuals passionately dedicated to keeping our nation safe by keeping illicit drugs and transnational criminal organizations at bay. Some of us here today are old enough to remember First Lady Nancy Reagan's Just Say No campaign. Anybody remember that? Over 35 years ago, it's hard to believe our fellow citizens can't say no to substances which sap their strength and intellect, lead them to financial ruin, bring crime to their neighborhoods, and take their lives. Drug overdoses are now the leading cause of death among Americans under the age of 50, with over 59,000 deaths estimated in this last year. That is an absolutely stunning number. It's roughly equivalent to the number that were lost in action in the Vietnam conflict. So that was just 1 year last year. Make no mistake, the scourge of illicit drug trafficking impacts our national security. Firstly, drug use significantly reduces the number of persons eligible to serve. As it is, less than 30% of the population is eligible to serve based on age, physical health, and all the different factors. And drug use excludes about 10%. And once in service, we continue to lose fully qualified service members to illicit drug use. Second, where transnational criminal organizations develop mutually beneficial alliances with terrorists or insurgent groups and share infrastructure, financial networks, and logistical corridors, crime and corruption climb and lead to ever-growing instability, increasing their financial means and generating greater opportunities for each of these organizations to thrive. It is absolutely astonishing. People will inject, snort, swallow, and or smoke poisons that can kill them, because ultimately, if there was no market for these drugs, drug cartels would cease to exist, just like 8-track tapes, Lombards, and the Ford Pinto. Until that day comes, I will use every ounce of my energy to support our partners in law enforcement and their efforts to keep every ounce, gram, pill, and kilo of drugs out of this country. Rear Admiral Schneider, thank you so much for presiding over the ceremony today. Unfortunately, as people mentioned, General Buchanan could not be here. He's on a mission for our friends and partners in Puerto Rico, and I would be remiss if I didn't take a moment to acknowledge the struggles that they have. I have a good friend, Brigadier General Reyes, who's the Director of Joint Staff out there in Puerto Rico, and I know he's got his hands full, as well as the Texas National Guard that is still working through the impacts of the hurricane there. But I do want to convey to General Buchanan and General Robinson remotely that I promise to give this command my all. I will live the Army values and be the leader this amazing organization deserves. General Crytzer, you are an impossible act to follow. Thank you so much for your hospitality. I wish you and your family the best of luck. And finally, to Joint Task Force North, I look forward to the next 2 years as we get to know each other and continue our successes. Our mission has never been more critical, and your efforts are vital in reaching our goal, protecting the homeland. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand now for the playing of the Armed Forces Medal. The lyrics are in your program. Please join us in singing. Please remain standing for the departure of special guests and family.